Okay. By the way, it's Adirondacks for me again. So I just dug a hole. I've got some boards and old debris to throw in this hole. So, it's a good size hole. Alright, so that's going to be it for right now. Be back with you later. Adirondacks for me here again. Well, there used to be a chimney there. I don't know if you can see the hole in the wall. When a building is neglected for 25, 30 years, that's what's going to happen. So that's stuff I have to address in addition to the roof. So I got a load of the old blocks and inner tile that I got to take over to that hole I dug and get it buried. Oh, got a little bit of a smudge going here today to keep the bugs away. They're really not that bad, but I think the smudge has a lot to do with it. So there's just a little bit of block left on the very base of that chimney that I've got to break away. I'm sure there's a cement slab underneath there that it's stuck to. So we're getting closer to getting to the roof. Alright, that's gonna be it for right now. I got the four-wheeler and the trailer all loaded up, ready to go. I salvaged a couple more blocks that were not too bad a shape from the chimney that I put over there off to the side. Alright, so that's gonna be it for right now. We'll catch up to you later. Okay, I got the chimney down and I got all the debris cleaned up from it. So that's one less thing to get in my way when I'm starting the roofing. Oh, so I'm going to unload the trailer and park that over there and cover it up. I think I might move the backhoe here and trim some more trees out on the building area lot. All right, so that's going to be it for right now. We'll get back with you soon. Clean up. Adirondacks for me back again. Well, I got this inexpensive drone, as you know from previous videos. Well, this thing went out of control and it's not smart enough to come home when it loses Wi-Fi connection to your phone. So this thing flew up into the woods up onto my property. I'll scan around here and give you a view here of some of the woods. We call it the sugar bush area because it's where I have lots of maple trees that my buddy taps in the wintertime. This is a little bit down from it, so there's not a lot of maples here, but there's a lot of big white pine in here and cedar. So anyways, this drone has a mind of its own. It takes off and goes to hell bent on election. I figured that was the end of the drone. I'd never find it again. But I used the Wi-Fi signal strength meter to isolate it in the evening, and I had about an hour's worth of LEDs flashing on it before the battery died. Never ever would have found it if I hadn't had any batteries still active in it. So the strength increased until I got in the area, and I just did a circle pattern, kept looking up in the trees. And eventually I did find it flashing up there, so I marked the spot. Now I'm back today. Looks like I'm going to have to cut down at least one maple tree. Not that big a maple tree to free it up. Hopefully that will do it, but I'll leave this running and you can watch the results.
Here we go.
I freed it up. We'll go over and take a look at it. Clean up the tree that I cut down. And show you the drone that came down. Okay, so there she is, rescued once again. I think this is the fourth time. One of these times I'm gonna run out of luck and I'm gonna lose it. All right, that's it for now. I don't think you have to see me clean up this mess, but there's the maple tree that I had to cut. Okie doke. Catch you later. Oh, it's a beautiful day. I got my drone back. Now I'm just sitting up at the location where eventually I will build. Oh, beautiful breeze blowing. I finally got the flag up after taking the old cedar pole down that was rotted. This pole was here and existing. So I just got new hardware, rope for it, new flag, got her put up. There's my view. Right now I'm just sitting on the four-wheeler in the shade here from this big pine tree that I trimmed a while back. Old Glory is actually blowing in the wind a little bit. Oh, but the breeze feels great. Skies are blue, as you can see. Just a beautiful day to relax. So I did enough chainsawing to get the drone down out of the tree. Hopefully this isn't too shaky. It seems like when I hold the phone and move it around, it gets super shaky. There's the big tree that's given me the shade that I had trimmed up as high as I could with the backhoe. There's a few more branches I'd like to get, but I'm not too worried about it at this point. Still haven't got to those other trees over there yet, but I got the backhoe on another job right now, so I'm just going to have to wait. I gotta, when it cools off a little bit more tonight, I gotta mow this area again. Oh, big old, what is that, a buzzard? Guess he thinks I'm dying. He circled me, see if I was still alive. That looked definitely like a buzzard. Had a head that was ugly, and buzzard heads are ugly. You can see my truck. I got it parked way down there at the other end of the field. I'm anxious to start trimming out these trees here to improve the view. Don't know if I'll get to it this summer before I head south in the RV, but I will get to it eventually. But definitely, you know, high priority for the month of August is to get the workshop stabilized with the roof and the walls. Okay, I'm just going to sit back on the four-wheeler, enjoy this nice, beautiful shade and breeze, and beautiful August day. Talk to you again soon.